So they are taking a break, and as you just saw, they confirmed the vote was 55 to 45 on whether to call witnesses, to subpoena witnesses, or require documents be provided. Lisa Desjardins, it was broader than just the request for Congresswoman Herrera Beutler. So this does open up the possibility that others could be called, and that means the defense potentially could be calling witnesses. Lisa, I have to ask you, is there a separate vote on each witness who is called or not?
This is what I'm asking now. It's my recollection from the first impeachment trial that we didn't expect there to be separate votes on each witness and procedure going forward if the general topic of witnesses was allowed. Remember, there was that question last year about John Bolton and whether he would be called as a witness. And my recollection is that the first step in that was that the Senate had to approve witnesses in general. And then after that, that there would be separate discussion is how I understood it. And in theory, the way that I remember that was going to work, if it happened, was that there was going to have to be another resolution passed detailing how the witness portion would work of the trial. That's the ideal here, I think, for the Senate to operate, that there would be an agreement of some sort or some kind of resolution that would pass. But as we've seen, Judy, to get any resolution passed through the Senate, including for it to operate itself, sometimes has taken weeks with this Senate. Obviously, this is a group of lawmakers who are eager to move forward with this trial. They, I'm sure, want to figure this out as quickly as possible. But that's why we're in a quorum call. Whenever you see a quorum call like this, which is really sort of a name for establishing who's in the chamber, telling senators they should come to the chamber, it's really just a way to buy time for the leaders to figure out what's going on and for senators to figure out what's going on themselves. As we saw, senators have the same questions that you do about what they just voted on, which, as a side note, is an extraordinary example of how the modern Senate has been ruled really by leaders and by script. When the modern Senate faces a situation like this, where they're making decisions minute by minute, you can see that this is not something that they really have the muscles for. Perhaps the Senate of the 1800s did, but this Senate is confused when there's not a script and they're trying to figure out what's going on.